Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Today, I'm going to show you how to create the look of the computer screen in the movie The Matrix and how to embed a face into it. If you're working on Windows, open Notepad, or if you're on a Mac, open a similar text editor like TextEdit or BBEdit. Drag any random image into your text editor. After a few moments, it should fill with random characters. We want to find a huge block of text that doesn't have a lot of space between characters. Click to the left of a character, scroll down, and when you have approximately this much of text, shift-click to the right of a character to highlight the block of text. Press Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Minimize the text editor and open Photoshop. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N. Make the width 1550 pixels, the height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Shift and the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Open Contents and click Black. Then click OK. Open your Vertical Type tool. Open your list of fonts, or if you already know the name of the font that you'd like to use, just type it in. I'm using Benographic Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in the video's description or project files. Make its size 6 points, the anti-aliasing none, and left alignment. Click the color box, and in the hexadecimal field, type in 00FF0C. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Place your cursor at the top left corner of your document and drag a text box to the lower right corner. Go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Make sure the vertical and horizontal scales are 100% and the baseline shift is 0 points. Make the leading 6 points. Leading is the amount of space between lines of text. In the Tracking field, click 0. Tracking is the amount of space between characters. It's also known as kerning. Go to the top left corner and press Ctrl or Command V to paste your text into your document. Then, click the check mark to accept it. Make a copy of your text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. It may take Photoshop a minute to process. Make the leading 10 points. Again, Photoshop may need some time to process it. Make the tracking also 10. Make another copy of your text, and this time make the leading 14 and the tracking 25. Once it processes, we can close the character panel. Next, we'll give our text depth. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the top text layer. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Make the middle text layer active and place a layer mask next to it. Repeat the last filter, which is the cloud filter, by pressing Ctrl or Command F. We'll darken the midtones of this layer mask to give our image a bit more depth. To do this, open your Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command L. Drag the input midtone slider to the right approximately this much, then click OK. Next, we'll add random depth by opening your brush tool and Brush Picker. Make the size approximately 150 pixels and the hardness 0%. The opacity and flow are 100%. Make sure black is your foreground color and then randomly brush over your image to mask out more areas of the layer mask. Click the top layer mask to make it active and brush over your image again to mask out areas from this layer mask. We're going to copy the three top layers. To do this, Shift-click on the bottom text layer to highlight all of them and press Ctrl or Command J to copy them. Merge the copies into one layer by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Now, drag the merged layer below the original layers. Let's rename it. Double-click the characters and press Ctrl or Command A to select the name. Type in Motion Blur. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Make the angle 90 degrees and the distance 20 pixels. Uncheck and check Preview to see your image without and with the effect. We're ready to add a face to the matrix screen. First, make a composite snapshot of your image. To do this, make your top layer active and press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. We'll rename the layer Comp Snapshot. Open a photo of someone that you'd like to embed into the matrix. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. Press Ctrl or Command 0 to fit it onto your canvas. We want to make a selection just around the head. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. I'm using a size of 10 pixels. However, if you're using this tool as well, you may want to adjust this amount depending on the size and resolution of your image. Drag your tool over your subject's head. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Click the Refine Edge button or go to Select and Refine Edge. I did an in-depth tutorial on Refine Edge, so if you're not familiar with this feature, you should watch that tutorial. I placed its link in the video's description. Drag the radius to the right and check Smart Radius. Brush over the hair and output it as a new layer. Remove all its color by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift U. To adjust its brightness and contrast, open your Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command L. Slide the output shadow to where the histogram starts to rise, and do the same for the input highlight. To place it into your other document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the matrix image. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto your image and release. To resize and position the head, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If your subject is too large to see it entirely, press Ctrl or Command 0 to see the Transform's entire bounding box. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. The result will look best if the size of the head is large. Drag it to the center and resize it if you need to. Then press Enter or Return and fit it back onto your canvas. Next, we'll save the head as a displacement map, thereby making the text look like it's wrapping itself around the head. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop. For its name, type in Displacement, save it as a Photoshop PSD file, and check as a copy. Then, click Save. If you see this message, click OK. Control-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the head to make a selection of its shape. Click off the eyeball next to the head to hide the layer. Make the composite snapshot active and go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Make the horizontal and vertical scales 10, stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. Then click OK. Click the displacement document and click Open. Notice inside the selection, the text became distorted. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Make the head visible and active. Change its blend mode to soft light. Make two copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice and change the blend mode of the top copy to overlay. Next, we'll make the head more discernible. Make the composite snapshot active and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.